late, and Rommels comes out fainting. This is his lead. Cautious but focused. He wants to reveal too much early on, give away too many openings. Good double left hook from Winter. Not straightforward combination to throw, ball to land, but he managed it. That's his fast lanes go. But his defence is organised there. Blocks them with his gloves. He steps in attacking, letting hooks go. But it was Winter who finished the exchange. On his right. Both are headhunting really. Neither have started attacking the body yet. And he set up well his left hook. Good straight right first. Sort of stamped his foot there with a feint, just trying to trick Winter into a mismove. Winter didn't feel good. And it's easily clear for a body shot and flips back in. Trying to brace his own punches. Although Winter was pressing there, he did well off the ropes. Lean back into them, leaning clear. He caught Winter, but he was not attacking. Spunts Winter's pressing in. A cluster of blows. Close first round, technical stuff, not much to separate them. The scoring system in amateur boxing has changed over the last couple of years. In the last Olympics, and in recent history, it was a computer point scoring system where the judges were essentially logging the blows. That all changed in 2013, and it became a 10 points musket. So that's where the judges score around 10-9 or 10-8 to the winning boxer. So much more like professional boxing in that sense. That allows a little bit more style to be appreciated, maybe. But one like this, it's hard to judge, and it could well just come down to whoever the judges reckon has landed the most leather. Centre of the ring, perhaps a sign of control, but he is moving well around the outside. He's giving as good as he's got in that exchange in the neutral corner. A stalking his man. Not great urgency, more caution. Again, even though they're well matched and know that if he makes a mistake, James Leighton Rumbles will be able to capitalise on it. Him into the corner.
Two places now, James.
Good double jab from Winter. Set up his right. And now getting after James Lee with more aggression. Left out, not landing it, but holding that out stopped Winter from getting in towards him. So, for a defensive move. And Winter gets to tussle in close. He does try to let his hands go, but doesn't manage to really get much on his opponent. It's a close bout. Can well come down to the last round. Third and final round's coming up in just a minute's time. Islington, so you'd expect Tyrone Winter to be able to finish strong in the last. He may need to as well. Fought his way off the ropes. Winter's right repelled that particular attack from the Rumbles man. Well, Rumbles youth, to be honest. Dangerous with his back to the ropes. As soon as he touches those ropes and knows it's time to let his own fist fly. And that has thwarted Winter's attempts. Take the most of those chances. He hit the right there, landed it, and cycled away from there. Just wait, brings the left of the cross now. Just that might be seen more of a slap. hands it around your punch with the knuckle part of the glove, but in your slap sometimes can just stop the opponent in his tracks and turn him away. Sort of sat back into the bottom rope, sway flare, got himself caught. Again, into banged in, flush right, and was bringing it back out up in the air just to. He was holding his hand up to remind everyone that he'd landed that shot.
Lead off, James, 10 seconds left! Good shot! Good boy, James, keep working now! Work now, James!
Very well fought. Well, held the centre of the ring for the most part that last round. It could actually have been Rumble's James Lee who landed the more shots. He might have nicked it in the end, but we'll see how the judges have it momentarily. Decision there for James Lee from Rumbles. Islington's Corrine Winter isn't happy, but it was a close